Off the Streets is a youth club, and the reason why it's called Off the Streets is because young people are coming off the streets. I just think it's a home from home.
These people out here doing crime, they're choosing to do so out of boredom, peer pressure and frustration.
They get empowered, they get access to jobs. I know it's gone well because of the register and how many young people come in here and how they've grown as well. Storm began basically because of what I was actually going through. Coming from domestic violence, I wanted to empower single women.
Computer is made up of two integral parts.
Storm offers classes for single mums and women who want to improve their lives. All the women that work for Storm are passionate. The reason why they're passionate, because they came here to Storm as desperate women, not having anyone, having no faith in them. And now that, you know, they've gone onto universities, it's amazing. And they can't believe, their families can't believe it. So I want the same thing for Off the Streets. Off the Streets is a 10-week pilot project, which is funded by the Metropolitan Police. A lot of mums were coming to me and saying, like, their children were getting into trouble. Children were getting attacked on the street. My son was stabbed, and that was really heart-rending for me. I don't even want to imagine how it is to lose a child with gun and knife crime.
I've been involved in it, and I've been arrested for it, been to prison for it. At my age now, at 34, 35, I can speak to the youth and tell them that it's basically wrong, not good, non-progressive, and it's only going to put you in a cycle. Because when I was that age, no one weren't telling me that.
But I didn't want to say, is there an alternative, and have no alternatives in place, because the young people wouldn't actually listen to that. I'm at the top, where the top's where I want to be. Being at the bottom of the poverty.
I'm real hungry now, so please don't bother me. Opportunities. Mistress funeral was emotional. I don't want to come to none of you lot's funerals. I don't want to hope I can see you lot 10 years from now. Don't have to go to none of you lot's grave or visit none of you lot in jail.
What happens in airing out sessions is basically a chance for these youths to say anything they like, whatever they feel strongly about.
Real talk, if man's gonna have money in 10 years' time, what is man doing towards that?
Buy a shop in Kenya.
Buy a shop in Kenya? Tell you, why Kenya, fam?
Because
it's poor.
When the youth start speaking, it opens up the doors for everyone else, and everyone starts speaking, everyone starts talking more about more serious stuff. It helps them communicate and air out what's deep down.
Just do something positive with your life still.
I'm trying to get in every day on the road, but from the Jakes we stay on the toes. Slow though's better than no though. So if you ain't getting though, jump on the stinger so we stay sure.
A lot of them like to do music, and the studio gives them an opportunity to put their words on paper, on tracks, and to see the finished products.
He breaks down the studio to the young people in telling them how to do songwriting, how to lay down tracks, how to do beats, aspects in studio work that you can do. A lot of the young people want to do like singing or be rappers, but obviously they're not going to all be that, but there's other avenues and ways that you could actually do music.
They had control over the beat, who made it, how it was made, who sang the chorus, how the chorus goes. It was all up to them, and making them be in that kind of environment where they can make something happen, it's good for their confidence.
For the kids, off the streets. Behave yourself, man. You know, it makes sense.
I don't know how much you know the statistics, but within the mental health services, black people are overrepresented, especially black men.
I work for the Mental Health Trust as a community development worker. I've been invited to do a talk on mental health to young people here.
Well, when he came, he had a lot of insight for the youth because he explained a lot of characteristics to do with mental health. So it will help them to look at themselves and be self-effacing.
Knowing what mental health is about is very important.
Basically, what I'm doing is putting together a project with Storm, allowing young people to have the opportunity to learn to drive.
I thought it was really imperative that young people knew that, you know, they cannot drive without a license and the consequences.
We're loading up theory test CDs so the kids who haven't got the opportunity to learn how to drive can come here and practice their theory and has a perception.
I love it. I love the fact that there is a driving school in here.
I think it's tremendous to have organisations that get young people off the streets into positive activities. But what is really important with a project like this is that it manages to integrate young people into the community.
Best thing about off the streets is getting the kids off the streets.
And it's great when people say to me, oh Marie, you're doing really a good job and yeah, this is what we need. But what annoys me is that we don't get the funding. My hopes, my dreams for off the street is for it to continue.
It should continue because people like me that's decided to turn their life around and will speak the truth to the youth, it makes me a bridge to the streets. When I speak to one and like something changes in his life, and if it's because of me and off the streets, then it's worthwhile if it's just one person.
I've got a 5-year-old child. I want these young people to be leaders for them, mentors, not for my son to pick up a knife.